Class 5 IMO Level 2. Mathematics question number 16. If the sum of 15 1 by 8 and 2 1 by 3 is 5 1 by 2 more than certain number x, then find the value of x. Given 15 1 by 8 plus 2 1 by 3 is equal to x plus 5 1 by 2. Converting it into improper fractions, then taking all the constants to one side and leaving variable to another side, then taking LCM and simplifying, we can find the value of x, that is 11, 23 by 24. Mathematics question number 17. How many pairs of intersecting lines are there in the given figure? Let us count. Now, there are more than 7 intersecting lines in the given figure. So, the answer is none of these. Mathematics question number 18. Find the perimeter of the shaded part of the given figure. Here is the shaded part. And one side of a square is 3.5 centimeters. So number of sides, that is 36, which measures 3.5 centimeters. So using this, we can find the perimeter, that is 126 centimeters. Mathematics question number 19. If the number of trees in a plantation is 5,200 when rounded off to the nearest 100, then what is the greatest number of trees in the plantation? The greatest number of trees in the plantation is equal to 5,249. Mathematics question number 20. The given table shows the time taken by 5 friends to finish their lunch. Who took more time than Manav to finish her lunch? Now first let us convert Manav's time into minutes. So Manav took 40 minutes and 40 seconds to eat his lunch. Now using the table, we can see that Arav takes 44 minutes. So Arav takes more time than Manav to finish his lunch. Mathematics question number 21. Which of the following figures has exactly two lines of symmetry? D1 has exactly two lines of symmetry. Mathematics question number 22. Select the incorrect option. The highest common factor of 75 and 125 is 25. Yes, this is true. The number of prime factors of 119 is 2. Yes, this is also true. Twice the difference between 8th multiple of 20 and 5th multiple of 17 is 75. 8th multiple of 20 is 160 and 5th multiple of 17 is 85. And the difference between these two is 75. So the twice the difference is equal to 2 into 75, that is 150. So this is wrong. Mathematics question number 23. What should be the number in the empty box? Let the unknown term be n. Given 1656 n multiplied by 18 is equal to 432. Using the given information, we have derived a equation. Let us see which of the options will satisfy this equation. Option A will not satisfy this equation, but option B will satisfy this equation. Mathematics question number 24. If tens digit and thousands digit in each of the following options get interchanged, then which option gives the estimate value of 45,500 when it is rounded off to the nearest hundredth place? In option A and option D starts with 54,000, but in the actual answer we need 45,000. So we can leave these two options. Now we can check the B option and the C option. In the B option, if we interchange the tens and thousands digit, we get 44,438, which when rounded off to is not equal to 45,500. But in the C one, if we interchange the tens and thousands digit, we'll get the value as 45,549, which can also be written as 45,500. Mathematics question number 25. The given table shows the postal rates at a postal office. Study it carefully and answer the following questions. How much amount is needed to send a local mail of weight 1460? First 50 gram rate is 1.50. After 50 gram, we have remaining 1410 gram. So for every 30 gram, they charge 40 pice. There are 47 30 grams in 1410. Therefore, postal rates for 1410 grams is equal to 18.80. So, total postal rate is equal to 20.3. Mathematics question number 26. Which shape has the largest area? Number of squares in P is equal to 10. So, area of P is equal to 90. Similarly, area of Q is equal to 99. Area of R is 90. and area of S is 90. So in short, here no need to find the area because every square is the same size. So by counting the squares itself, we can decide which shape has the greater area. That is the Q1. Mathematics question number 27. Which of the following options shows 15 degree Celsius more than the sum of temperatures shown on the thermometers? Sum of temperatures shown here is equal to 77 degree Celsius. So 15 degree more than this is equal to 92 degree Celsius. Mathematics question number 28. Find the value of PQ and P plus Q plus R. Multiplying 96 into 89, we can get the values of P, that is 8, Q, that is 6, R, that is 4. So adding this, we can get the value, that is 18. Mathematics question number 29. The given pictograph shows the number of visitors who visited the museum on given 5 days of a week. Study the graph carefully and answer the following questions. If free entry for each person is 125 rupees, then how much more money was collected on Wednesday than on Friday? Amount collected on Wednesday is equal to 125 into 300, which is equal to 37,500 rupees. Similarly, amount collected on Friday is equal to 25,000 rupees. 12,500 rupees more money was collected on Wednesday than on Friday. On which of the following 2 days, the total number of visitors was thrice the number of visitors on Thursday? Thrice the number of visitors on Thursday is equal to 450. If we add visitors from Tuesday and Friday, we get 200 plus 250, that is 450. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit that like button. Turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.